Hey guys, you're watching Halborn Flash Videos. I'm Arabdha, and today we have got Jorge Schnura from Unlocked Finance. Jorge, first of all, welcome to our Flash Videos. Thanks for joining in.
Thank you for having me. It's great to be here.
Great. So tell us a little bit about yourself. What's your story thus far?
Yeah, sure. So I'm Spanish, born in Madrid, Spain. And I've been always involved in startups, tech startups. I started a few of them. The first one was while I was studying at a university, and we did a startup called Taiba, which was it became the largest jobs marketplace for tech companies and startups in general in Europe. We sold that around 2015, I think it was. And we started working on a deep learning company where we used deep learning to analyze code of large corporations and give them insights into their software development lifecycle. So kind of like a BI, business intelligence, but on code, to draw an analogy. I also started an esports business called Mad Lions, which is now one of the largest esports organizations or esports teams worldwide. We merged our organization with a Canadian company called Overactive Media in 2019, and we took it public to the Toronto Stock Exchange last year. I've been investing in crypto since pretty early, since 2012. So last year when we went public, that's when I decided that the next thing I would do would be something professionally in crypto, not just investing personally. And that's when I decided to start Unlocked, which is the DeFi protocol to get NFT collateralized loans.
Wow, that's quite a journey. So from Taiba to Source to esports to Web3 and crypto, what has the journey been like so far for you?
Well, it's a lot of fun. Like I enjoy building things and figuring stuff out that is not figured, or trying at least to figure stuff out that's not being figured out yet. That's kind of like why the four startups have been in very different industries, because they were kind of like, when Taiba was, it was like the, not the start, but really the pickup of Web2. And, we were in that, and then machine learning, and then esports. Like I'm always fascinated by seeing industries, grow and take off and so on. So it's been very challenging. It's been a lot of fun. When you look at these things from outside, it looks like, straight line upwards, but the reality, it's more like a roller coaster with a lot of ups and downs, but it's been a fun ride.
Excellent. That's fascinating to hear. So tell us a little bit about Unlocked Finance. How did you start it? What's that all about?
Yeah. So the way we started was my co-founder, Carlos Otermin, and myself, we started talking. He's been always very into NFTs. I've been more into DeFi than into NFTs, I have to say. But that's good because we bring like two perspectives to the problem. And, one of the things that I've always been fascinated about is how small the lending or the debt market is in crypto compared to the underlying, right? Normally, when you look at traditional financial markets, debt is huge compared to the underlying. Sometimes it's, almost as big, and sometimes it's even bigger because of leverage, right? But in crypto, it's really tiny, right? And I've always wondered why. And, thinking more about it, became clear that, in crypto, most forms of debt are collateralized by liquid assets, by tokens. And that's, if you look at traditional finance, that's kind of like a niche use case where you use liquid assets to collateralize a loan, right? Because part of the utility of the loan is making something illiquid liquid, right? Yeah. So started thinking about like what are the illiquid assets in crypto, and those are NFTs, right? And then Carlos, he comes from starting his own guild, and he clearly saw the problem there as well with NFTs, where they're not liquid. It's a high opportunity cost to buy one versus doing something else. Mm-hmm. And in guilds, for example, or big NFT investors, they normally have cash flow issues because of that, right? So we decided to, that's why we decided to build Unlocked. And we started looking at what was out there in the, you know, NFT collateralized lending market. And we saw, you know, mostly NFTFi, which is a protocol we have a lot of respect for. And I think it has its use cases, right? But yeah. Then it has also its shortcomings in that it's a marketplace where you upload an NFT and people offer you loans against it. And that means that your real liquidity is actually only those people that see your loan and want to go through the hassle of negotiating a loan with you, right? So the real liquidity is actually quite low, and that results in very high interest rates. That results in very strict loans where you have no flexibility on time. They're not open-ended loans, et cetera, right? So we said, let's take the pool approach, right? And so, you know, Unlock uses pools or an ETH pool from which you can draw, you know, loans by collateralizing them with your NFTs, right? And the only, like, one of the challenges there is, you know, when it's peer-to-peer, both agree on like a price of the NFT and everything. Here you need the protocol to decide that for you, right? So instead of doing our own appraisal models, what we do is we leverage others like Upshot or NFT Bank, who have their own models for appraisal. And then we use our own risk framework to basically assign a loan to value to each individual NFT, right? Instead of using floor prices like some competitors, and instead of using arbitrary loan to value measures, we have a risk framework that analyzes the risk of every single NFT and gives it a loan to value based on that, basically. So that's basically how it works. One of the other benefits is you're going to be able pretty soon to keep the full utility of your NFT while using it as collateral. I always say, like, you know, imagine how many houses would be financed if you couldn't live in them until you've paid for the loan, right? Basically, probably very few. So it's right. You know, the factors are kind of what we're trying to solve with Unlocked.
Okay, that's really, really fascinating. And if you could sum up the, you know, the key value proposition, what differentiates you guys from the rest that are building on the same problem statement, what would you say that is in a couple of sentences?
Yeah, I think that, so our biggest mantra, I would say, is safety, not just in terms of technical security, which is why when we were looking for, you know, an auditor, we said we need to go with the best. But also in terms of, you know, safety of how safe is it to lend out in terms of the financial safety, right? That's right. Why we have this dynamic loan to value method, right? Where it really looks at the risk of every single NFT and reassesses that in real time versus giving like an arbitrary loan to value, right? As well as like the way we liquidate it is very different from competitors, and it makes it much more certain that lenders will recover their money and that there will be a surplus for the borrower that got liquidated in a loan. You know, like that's like our main mantra is making sure that lenders are not at risk of default, right? I think that's biggest difference. You know, after that, I would say it's the keeping the utility of your NFTs, which makes it then more usable.
Of course. And speaking about that, one of the first things I saw on your site when I was checking it out was the Unlock NFTs. What is that about?
The Lockey's NFTs is a way for us to, you know, gather our community or the community of the people who are the most passionate about what we're doing, and you know, giving them access. For example, when we launched testnet, they had access during 2 weeks to that testnet before anyone else, right? So it gives them the benefit of accessing that. It will give them the benefit of accessing mainnet before anyone else, of accessing new features before anyone else. In exchange for that, it's a controlled group of people we trust because they're part of our community that give us feedback on the product and allow us to improve it before we open it up to the whole public, right? And, you know, it's the way we thought about it from the beginning is, let's make it something where we don't make money out of it. So basically, you know, when we sold the initial mint of the Lockies, one of the perks that you get is that you get a cash back in Unlock tokens the moment we do the token generation event, right? So That way we know it's people who are committed to it, A, because there's not a fixed date for the token generation event. So it's people who are long-term committed to it. And right. B, because they're willing to spend ETH in exchange for unlocked tokens. So we're not really making anything of that because we give the cash back, but we know that the people who get them are people who are committed to helping us out, right?
Of course, that also makes for like a great, you know, like brand value allocation and loyalty there. So that's really great to hear. Congrats on your testnet and you know, the upcoming mainnet whenever that's out. Could you talk a little bit about your testnet and the upcoming mainnet, and what can the audience, our viewers, expect?
Yeah, so the testnet has gone pretty well. Like in terms of usage, we've had like thousands and thousands of transactions, which is something that we didn't expect, especially in the first part when it was only open for Lockey holders, right? So we see that there's, you know, that we have a strong community and that people are willing to engage there. So that's great. We're very happy with how the testnet came about. We had a lot of engagement from the community in reporting issues on tickets. We've been able to solve all of them. And it's been a great experience. And mainnet is you know, it's basically going to be a very polished version of the testnet. We've taken our time to do things right, especially in the type of market that we've been going through. There's not that rush anymore that maybe you saw, earlier. To get products to the market, to really push things quick and fast and so on. And we've been really able to push everything, to polish everything, right? And that's also part of our mantra in terms of safety, right? Not rushing things and not for them not being secure. And then, you know, for mainnet, we have, you know, some cool features there that were not part of testnet, like using part of the funds in the lending pool to deploy them on Yearn to earn some extra APY, right? The funds that are being unused by loans so that they don't sit idle, like liquidating NFTs, not just on our auction house and on NFTX, but also on SudoSwap. So depending on where we get the best value for the NFTs that are being liquidated, we liquidate them one place or the other, right? So you know, that's mainly, you know, what mainnet will bring about. And then after that, we'll be working on some very cool new features that we'll be announcing soon.
Okay, looking forward. That all sounds super fascinating. Well, we talked about safety, we talked about security. So I have to ask, what's your security approach and how did Unlocked go about it?
Well, first of all, for us, it was very important, like to really go with tier one auditor, right? That that it wouldn't just do one audit, you know, give us the report so that we can post it somewhere and for people to kind of see the check mark of it's been audited, right? But to have an ongoing relationship like we have with Halborn, where you know, it's a constant evaluation of any changes we make and any improvements we make, so that, you know, we're always on top of whatever we do being secure, right? This is also important, I think, to the speed, even, because many protocols they have to wait a lot until they push new improvements because they want to bundle many of them and just pay one audit instead of, right, you know, having an engagement that is ongoing. We think if there is a place where a protocol needs to invest, it's where it's worth it, it's precisely this, right? So, you know, we're working with Halborn. We're also doing a bug bounty program, you know, so that the community can also find things. But yeah, be it on the, you know, security side in terms of auditing and such, or be it on the more financial engineering side, the safety is the most important part, because we now, especially in this market, it's a market to build reputation. It's not a market, yes, to rush things and to go and just grow like crazy. It's a market to really show everyone that what you're building is serious, it's secure, it's solid, it's professional, right? And that their funds are going to be safe, right? And that, you know, it's a safe model to invest your funds in. That's for us the most important part.
Okay, no, thank you for sharing the security journey thus far. It's been an absolute pleasure. talking to you and learning a little bit more about Unlocked. So to end with, since you have had a very fascinating journey thus far, if you could possibly look back and give yourself a bit of an advice, something that you wish you had known before, what would that be?
Well, I think, you know, it kind of depends on which of my startups I look at, right? But I think generally, and this is like very cliche, but it's one thing to say it and it's a very different thing to then go and execute it, right? I would say generally always, like, you know, fall less in love with what you're doing with your product, because when you fall too much in love with it, you are afraid sometimes to go out to the market and try to sell it in case, you know, it's because it's not quite there yet, right? It's like, I don't know, you want your child to be, you know, perfectly dressed up and prepared to for whatever it's going after, right? So falling a bit less in love with the product you're building, I think that's like a very high level piece of advice that I wish I would have followed more at the beginning of my entrepreneurial experience.
That's a unique and an interesting one. It's often like it's kind of like the differentiator between an artist's approach and an entrepreneur's approach to, you know, rapid testing and going forward. Definitely great piece of advice. Thank you again, Jorge, for joining us in, and looking forward to all the Unlocked updates very soon. Thanks.
Thank you.